All right, welcome everyone. Thanks for having me here today. I'm very happy to be here with you. My name is Arnaud. I'm a cloud architect at Microsoft. I'm working on a digital transformation project with our customers worldwide. And I'm here to talk to you today about the cloud adoption framework and the landing zones for Terraform for Microsoft Azure. So I'm one of the creator of the landing zones on Terraform, and really it's part of the cloud adoption framework. And first things first, cloud adoption framework is really Microsoft one-stop voice on cloud adoption and how to get on Azure from the right fit. So it's all about defining your strategy, understand what are you trying to achieve when moving to Azure. Do you want to optimize your cost by taking your machines from your on-premises environment to Azure? Or do you want to take benefit of this migration to move towards a more transformative approach using DevOps for everything, governance, infrastructure, application? That's all of these things that we need to define first. And of course, going through the planification stage, talking about technical planification, but also people planification and qualification. And then jumping to the ready stage where we are talking about technical artifacts like the first landing zone, working on the blueprint, validating that and iterating on that to migrate existing workloads and to innovate and leverage a platform as a service feature or serverless computing with Azure Functions, for instance. And all of those stages, you have to keep an eye and automate everything you can on the governance and the management. So that's really the whole guidance that the cloud adoption frameworks provides you. And if you look on aka.ms/caf, this is where you're going to find all of those details about those different steps that I just very quickly touched. But there's of course one aspect we're going to cover today, which is the landing zone. So landing zone, historically, if we look at it, the way it has been defined, it is to basically define all the fundamental elements, all the guardrail, the security mechanisms, the logging mechanisms that we put on a subscription before it's getting ready to be used by application, consumer, by business units, environment. So in a way, not bringing a lot of value. So we are basically taking an approach where landing zone should actually do, of course, the governance guardrails that are very, very important, but also deploying the environment, the infrastructure as code, and also, I would say, all the things that are related to the application. And if it's an IaaS services, that's good. If it's a PaaS, a platform as a service, that's totally fine as well. And that's delivering the world environment. So you guessed it, in a way. What we are exactly doing with the landing zone is facilitating the infrastructure as code and the everything as code onto an environment because we really want to help our customer moving to Azure to adopt DevOps and to adopt all the advantage of cloud automation and cloud mechanisms. So all the aspect of DevOps, which is much more reliability, much more often deployment, much more visibility on the deployment, and a much more collaborative way. And this is one thing that we found working pretty well, which is having a declarative language with Terraform. You're really able to integrate different people around the table. So you can have the networking, the security, the apps team, the core infra team, all sitting together, working on the code base, iterating on the code base. And it's not only about the code base. As you see, you store the code base and you iterate your code on GitHub, but also it's managing the configuration also on a Git repository. And of course, you see me coming, I'm going to talk about GitOps. So really being really transformative for the organization, managing Git as an ultimate source of truth to get your configuration and iterate on the configuration using Git mechanisms. Let's say, for instance, I'm going to make my network evolve. So I'm going to submit a pull request onto my networking configuration repository. On this pull request submit is going to validate my configuration into a test subscription, totally isolated. So you see, when I'm doing my full deployment inside my production, the code has been validated and tested many, many times previously during the pull request. So it's usually leveraging the code quality mechanisms that we have in software and bringing it to the DevOps for the infrastructure and the everything as code for enterprises. So that's really the approach that we wanted to have. And one of the fundamental aspects that we had in mind when we created that is the open source and community driven and community impact. So all of that happening on GitHub, publishing our GitHub landing zone for Terraform. And you are totally free to submit a PR, open an issue, and we're managing it, responding to it, and making it evolve. What we found is really, really important is to provide some guidance as well on what is an enterprise scale approach for infrastructure as code. How do you deploy, as you see in the example picture here, an enterprise scale environment when you have your multiple management group where you can contain your different business units, manage your different subscriptions at scale, let's say your management subscription, connectivity subscription, identity, and your application landing zone by themselves. So we really wanted to have a prescriptive, not only guidance on the architecture, but also giving you a lower entry cost to infrastructure as code by providing the artifacts that you can definitely directly clone from GitHub and start with it. Of course, it's part of Cloud Adoption Framework, and of course, as much as we can, we enforce best practices in a box by adding directly actionable recommendation already implemented and easily customizable into the code base. So, what are the components that we are publishing with those landing zones? Of course, you have the landing zone by themselves, which is really the complex, composed environment where you put all the elements together to deploy, let's say, a full environment, deploying the core of a networking environment, deploying my Azure Kubernetes environment on my landing zone, or deploying, let's say, my classic three-tier VM-based application. That's what we provide you with. We decompose that complexity of a landing zone by leveraging a set of modules. So those are curated modules that we do maintain, and those are available on GitHub, of course, and those are published out of the registry. So you can leverage that directly out of the registry. And there's another one that we have published in the registry as well, which is a new feature of Terraform 13, which is the provider. So now you have seen that you can leverage providers directly out of the registry. Well, we use and abuse that feature with our provider. And our CAF provider is really not here to, let's say, compete with the Azure RM provider, which is doing an absolutely fantastic job, but it's to add some features. And the main utilization we're doing of our provider now, the CAF provider, is for naming convention. So you can come with our set of four built-in naming convention, and you can customize that or leverage them directly out of the provider. And we provide also you guys with a set of artifacts that are very important. So first, the open source state management technique. So how do you store Terraform state on top of Azure Blob Storage securely? And how do you work in an enterprise in this mode? So that's totally here using vanilla technologies. And it's also providing you with the what we call the deployment rover, which is a set of DevOps tool, which is basically, as you would guess from the icon, a Docker container that we use to have a consistent development environment for basically the DevOps engineer. But as well, if you are using CI/CD pipeline, and if you are using Azure DevOps pipeline, Jenkins, Circle, GitHub Actions, then you're able to use directly the rover and articulate the deployment of the landing zone is the same exact way. So you don't have to customize and work too much details of the CI/CD environment. But rather than talking too much about this, let's just have a quick view on that on GitHub and on my machine. So if I now switch to the GitHub repository, you see that I'm now on the Azure CAF Terraform landing zone that we are having. And inside that, you have basically the dev container environment, the documentation, the integration testing, and the landing zone by themselves. And here you can see the set of landing zone we're providing you with, the foundations, the networking, and the launchpad. And you also see that the modules are directly accessible from here. So if I click on modules, you'll see that I'm directly sent to the Terraform registry. And you can see that we have the provider here that we're using for naming convention that you can instantiate if you're using Terraform 13. And here you have a couple of modules that we mentioned and that have been used a couple of times, as you can see, for the last month that we have been published it. So of course you can review them, you can leverage them directly out of the registry, but if you want, you're also able to go to GitHub and create your own variation, and you can just use it your on your side, or you want to contribute to the community. We are absolutely loving and encouraging that. So that's the quick view on the components. If we go back to the Azure official repository, what I'd really encourage you to do is you go into this repository, you just then can clone the repo. So you do a git clone on your environment, you follow the instruction on get started, and ultimately what you'll see is you're having your Visual Studio Code environment here, which you can use as a great editor for Terraform with now the official extension to write Terraform code. But as you see, I'm on my laptop, but I'm also directly incepted inside my Docker container. Because if you are seeing it, I don't have Terraform installed on my machine. But if I'm going here and I'm typing Terraform version, you see that I am on my dev environment and I'm running Terraform 13. And then I can have my deployment environment where I use the Rover. And Rover, as you mentioned, is really my orchestrator to do my deployment. So I can choose to deploy my landing zone and do my Terraform plan, apply, and destroy. And this really is the guy that facilitates me the local development on my machine, and that allows me to leverage the Azure state and secure the state. And then you can see that inside landing zone repository, here you have the landing zone code. And as you would see, we are extensively using Terraform 13 features. We're using for each on modules, and that allows us to write very easy code that you can then compose very easily. If you see here, I have definition of my needed resource group, my virtual networks with the specification of my network. And just by deploying and customizing those variables, I'm able to put at work a very complex environment very easily. So I encourage you very strongly, go to the repo, take that, have a little play on it with your Azure subscription. You can have a free Azure subscription, and you can totally make it work on your environment. So that's for the very quick overview of the component. Everything is documented, and you have get started guides to get fast on the environment. One of the important aspects that we have with the CAF Terraform Landing Zone is really a layered approach that we have to do our service composition. And what I mean by layered approach, we of course don't want you in enterprise environment to manage your complex deployment with different business unit, different geographies with one single Terraform state. That would be really, really bad. And we really want to have that prevented from happening. So this is why we created this hierarchy of levels, which are a way to categorize landing zones and to modelize different level of privileges that you would expect from landing zone. If we see the example of the launchpad, it's really the fundamentals of managing the different subscription, managing the state, managing the service principle. On top of that, you have level one, which are all the landing zones related to the security and compliance. And level two is about hub and spoke and the networking and the shared services. Level three is about the applications landing zone, like your AKS cluster, the web application firewall, as we mentioned. And level four is about the application itself, so the code of the application itself. And what you see is if you're level three, if you are the guy deploying your AKS cluster, an AKS cluster for an environment, then you want to have autonomy to create the cluster whatever you want and whichever way you want, and to store the state in whichever way you want. But there's still some dependency that you would assume that are not under your responsibility, that are managed by a different team, but you still need to read it to do your service composition. So by using a state, remote state reading, you're able to read what's present on level 2 for the networking topology and on level 1 for the auditing and security and compliance configuration, but you're not able to modify the state. You're just able to read it. So that's the model that we are using, and all of that is made by basically segregating the state into different repositories, whether you're using Azure Vanilla or whether you're using a Terraform Cloud, Terraform Enterprise, it will be different mechanisms, and then using the data remote source to read and compose out of that. So that's the model we use to create autonomy, but also create enterprise pattern, reusable pattern, and segregation of duties and responsibility, because ultimately all of that's going to run into different pipelines with different level of privileges. Talking about pipeline, just wanted to give you an overview of two versions that we are having of Landing Zone. First one would be, for instance, if you're using Azure DevOps, you would see that here I have on the left-hand side what I just showed you a couple of seconds ago, my Visual Studio Code and my edit and development environment using the Rover. And you can see that it's the same Rover I'm using in my pipeline. And the Rover is the Docker container triggered by Azure Pipeline CI/CD. And then I'm going to read my Terraform landing zone logic, my code. And then my landing zone configuration is to in another repository. So we are managing this separation of repository. We find that it's usually much more what we see in terms of enterprise environment. But there's no mandatory revision on that. It can be the same repository. So, of course, then the materialization of the different pipelines with the different variables will implement production, dev, QA, etc. etc. That's just a vision. And of course, if you're using TFE and TFC, then you see the logic here is just exactly the same, except that you're using TFE, TFC in the middle to basically pull the code from the VCS and then apply the configuration. Whether with central services in Terraform Cloud or with distributed private environment into your environment if it's Terraform Enterprise. So that's a very quick overview that we see in terms of the deployment of the landing zone. So it's all the mechanisms that you know from TFE and TFC. It's leveraging workspaces to store the different state and the different configuration, using possibly the different the private registry for the different modules, and pulling the information from the different version control system. Could be Azure DevOps, GitHub, etc., etc. And then that's what materializes the deployment, and you can enrich it, of course, with Sentinel policies. Use the pre-configured CIS benchmark to verify the compliance at the plan stage. So let me do a very quick demo of now leveraging Terraform Cloud and using our landing zone. So just a quick disclaimer, I recorded this demo a couple of weeks ago on Terraform Cloud using Terraform 13 beta edition, because that's what was available at the time. It works at, of course, with the GA version. I didn't have time to refer to the demo, but trust me, it's the same mechanisms, and it's very easy to move from the code base that is on the public to the TFC edition just by adopting quickly the code.
In this demo, we're going to use Terraform 13 on HashiCorp Terraform Cloud to deploy Azure Cloud Adoption Framework Landing Zone. So we are now on GitHub, where we have our different sample landing zone. And first one is CAF Foundation. That's going to set the foundation for my subscription. And I'm also going to use Hub and Spoke to apply a classic Hub and Spoke topology, where we have an environment using Azure Firewall, Key Vault, etc., etc. So I'm going to fork this into my Azure DevOps environment. And you can see this is the same exact landing zone I'm going to have. And I'm going to clone that locally in order to be able to edit my environment. So I'm now in Visual Studio Code. And when you are in Visual Studio Code, you can see the different landing zones here. And if we take the example of CAF Foundation, we have our configuration principles and our settings here with this environment. Now we're going to look into a little bit more details on the main config file, and you can see that by default we come with the configuration using Azure Storage as a backend, but we are going to change that now to use Terraform Cloud as a backend. So you see now I'm using appterraform.io and I'm going to use the workspace test landing zone CAF foundations. So I already done the login, and now let's just go to Terraform Cloud in order to configure that. So you can see that here I have my different workspace, and I'm going to add a new workspace to specify this configuration. So I'm going to go and select my Azure DevOps environment, but I can use any type of source code environment. I'm going to use Azure Terraform, the repo I just showed you, and I'm going to use TFC here for this particular environment. I'm going to specify advanced option. And for that, I'm going to specify the working directory for the landing zone CAF foundation. And I'm going to specify a specific branch I have, which is TF13. And I'm going to create the workspace. Now, once it's done, I can start and review the configuration. I've configured my variables here to connect to the Azure subscription. And I'm going to select that I'm going to run Terraform 13 inside this an execution environment. I'm saving the settings and I'm able to queue my first environment. So now you see that I'm going to deploy foundations. And of course, I'm going to accelerate some of the sections. You see that the plan is being triggered and is running now. You can see the different sections that we're having, and you can see that you need to confirm in order to apply the configuration. So looks good to me. We're going to confirm the plan. So actually the configuration is going to be applied. If we fast forward a little bit, you can see that all the components are being deployed in as we speak. And here we go. We can configure now the other landing zone, which is the hub and spoke, since this one has finished. So how do we do that? Same thing. I'm going to go into my main. And here you see that I have configured my test landing zone hub and spoke to store my backend. But in Cloud Adoption Framework landing zone, we do service composition. So I'm going to read my test landing zone CAF foundations from one level down into another workspace. And I don't even have to change anything in my code for that to happen. Here I have added my hub and spoke configuration, and same thing, I'm going to just queue a plan for it. And you see that it's going to take a couple of minutes to verify the plan, seeing that I have 44 resources to add. And then I can just do the apply on this environment, confirm that I want to apply all of those settings. And of course, I'm going to fast forward that because it's taking a couple of minutes. And you can see that I can customize and do my composition by using, for instance, here, CAF Foundation. So as soon as I detect a change inside CAF Foundation, then I will trigger a plan also for this hub and spoke environment. So if you do that, you see that foundation's applied. I'm applying hub and spoke right now. So let's try to do a change. And I'm going to go into CAF Foundation, and I'm going to do a very little change. I'm going to change, for instance, here, the tags that I'm going to use in my environment. So I'm going to do Terraform TFC. Then I'm going to commit this change into my Git repository inside Azure DevOps. And you see that after a couple of seconds, it's going to detect there's a change. So that's what you see, the planning, cost estimation, and needs confirmation. So if you do that, you see automatically the update tag, the name I used in my commit, is triggered here. And you see that I have this OK update tag. So now I confirm the plan, and the apply is going to be queued in my environment. So once I've done that, you can see that I'm applying the change in CAF Foundation. And automatically, after it has finished, I will be triggering a plan also inside the hub and spoke environment. So this is what we're seeing here. And we see that the planning operation has started. I can review the changes. And if I'm OK with those, you can see it's just tags. I can just say OK, update tags. I confirm the plan. Then it's going to trigger the run of the configuration. I can go to my Azure subscription, and I can see that I have my public IP. I have my Azure firewall. And you can see that without changing much in my code, I'm able to apply my landing zones for Microsoft Azure using Terraform Cloud and using Terraform 0.13.
Okay, so that's it. How you deploy TFC, and how you use TFC to deploy Cloud Adoption Framework landing zone, a couple of sample landing zone. This is really an example leveraging Terraform 13. We are going to publish much more guidance on how to do that and also automate all the creation of TFE TFC. So stay tuned, we're going to blog and publish about that later. What I wanted to cover now a little bit is a very important aspect. As we mentioned previously, we really welcome, encourage, value contribution. We are really at a point where we are starting to see contribution now for quite a couple of months from customer partners, even Microsoft consultant adopting it and contributing it to the repo from all over the world. So if you have an idea, open an issue. If you have more than the ID but the implementation, submit a PR. We're totally happy looking forward to any PR. We're trying to manage that in the open, as well as creating boards inside GitHub and documenting the epic inside the issues, so we are able to be open on what's coming next and what we're going to include into the version. There's also usage that we're doing of Gitter, so if you want to chat with us and within the community, totally happy to have you on the AZTF mode channel of Gitter. There's a link on the GitHub repository, and that's really very, very important for us to see that happening. Now, having said that, we're dedicated to provide all the fundamentals, as you mentioned, the core of guardrails, the core of networking, and fundamental stuff that you need. But also what we are finding very important is the application landing zone. As I was mentioning, we have very active working groups now that are working on Azure Kubernetes Services, AKS landing zones. So you can have your complete and complex environment, including all the things you need to have your AKS, having your ingress controller, having your security stack, having everything. And we're working to have that totally stacking up. Remember the stacking model that we have. That's totally what we are working on and covering those different scenarios. So there are already active working group that you find on GitHub and that you can contribute. I put the link into this presentation. Same thing for data and AI. So if you want to use Azure Machine Learning Workspace, Synapse, all of these capabilities, same thing. We have a simple landing zone that you can use, stack on top of the existing one, and get fast to adding value and reuse the blueprint inside your environment. I listed another one, Azure Image Gallery, leveraging Packer, using our Rover container. There's so many stuff coming in this area as well. So stay tuned, monitor the GitHub repository, and happy to have you join those working groups and contribute based on what you need. And as I mentioned, contribution can be a pull request or can be just an issue or a plus on an issue to say, hey, we need that. We're really looking forward to that. So that's really, really important aspect to us. Having said that, that's it for today's session. I really wanted to make sure that you understand that Cloud Adoption Framework for Azure, it's really something that is here to help you accelerate. And we're dedicated to provide you not only with guidance on how to be successful with Terraform on Azure, but also provide you with artifacts that you can leverage, best practices on the adoption, on the automation of all of this in order to have reusable patterns, really have these reference architectures and blueprints that you can use with Terraform and giving you the choice of what is the best toolset. So CAF landing zone, Cloud Adoption Framework, and HashiCorp Cloud Operating Model, of course, better together, leveraging Terraform, leveraging the whole stack of technology, adding Terraform Cloud, Terraform Enterprise, Vault, and beyond to get the most out of your Azure deployment and as fast as possible. With that, don't forget aka.ms/tf-landing-zones. You can star the repo there and you can watch, and it will allow you to get on all the latest updates. We have daily updates on the content, and looking forward to your issue, pull request, or feedback on utilization. On that, if you have any questions, I am available. And if not, again, I want to thank you so much for your attention. You can reach out to me at aka.ms/Arno. I'm also available on Twitter and super happy to interact with you guys.
Thank you, Arnold. 우선은 저희 유튜브 라이브 채팅창 보시면 아시겠지만 질문들도 계속 해주고 계세요. 그래서 저희 또 이 발표해 주셨던 분들 중에서 이제 질문에 답해 주시는 분들도 계실 거고, 그리고 또 저희 뭐 하시코프 팀들이 또 같이 보고 있는 것 같아요. 그래서 활발하게 질의응답 해주시면은 저희가 답변을 드리도록 하겠습니다. 이제 잠시 쉬었다 가겠습니다. 지금 몇 시죠? 3시 10분까지 여러분들 휴식 시간 가지시고요. 커피 한잔 하시고 또 3시 10분에 활기찬 모습으로